9th Standard Geography Chapter 8 Industries of Karnataka Exercises First main, fill in the blanks with the suitable words. First one, the first iron and steel industry of Karnataka was established at dash. Answer is Bhadravati. Second one, the Manchester of Karnataka is dash. Answer is Davanagere. Third one, the byproducts of sugar are? Answer is bagasse and molasses. Fourth one, Ammasandra has dash industry. Answer is cement. Fifth one, Silicon Valley is the name of dash city. Answer is Bengaluru. Second main, discuss in groups and answer the following. First one, write a note on the industrial development in Karnataka. Answer is Sir M. Visheshwaraya's contribution to the development of industries in Karnataka is remarkable. Believing in the motto, industrialize or perish, he laid the foundation for many industries in the state. After the hydroelectric power generation station was started at Shivanasamudra in 1902, many industries producing essential goods and products for daily use came into existence. Rice mills, tile factories, beads and cigarettes, iron and brass foundries were established. After 1923, many modern manufacturing units like iron and steel, soap factories, cotton and silk mills, paper, cement, paint, sugar, sandal oil industries, etc. were started. After independence, the industrial policy of the central government enabled further industrial development in the state. As a result, many more factories were established. For instance, manufacture of aeroplanes, engineering, machine tools, watches, iron and steel, aluminium, information technology, electronic biotechnology industry, etc. These are all about the industrial development in Karnataka. Let's move to second question. Explain the iron and steel industry of Karnataka. Karnataka occupies the pride of place by being the first state in South India to establish an iron and steel factory. Sir M. Visheshwaraya's foresight enabled an iron and steel industry to be set up at Bhadravati in Shivamogga district in 1923. So that the rich and abundant iron ore deposits in the Baba Budangiri hills could be utilized, this factory was named as Mysuru Iron and Steel Industries Limited, MSIL. Later on, it was handed over to Steel Authority of India Limited or SAIL in 1989. Today it is known as Visheshwaraya's Iron and Steel Industry or VISL. The iron ore necessary for this factory is supplied from Kemmangundi, lime from Bandikutta, water from the Badra River and manganese from Sandur. In the beginning, firewood was used for the blast furnace. After the Sharavati hydropower generating station was established, hydroelectricity began to be used. At present, a special variety of steel and pig iron are produced. Another important iron and steel industry of Karnataka is the private sector owned Jindal Vijayanagar Steel Limited. It was established in 2001 at Thoranagal in Bellary district using the latest Corex technology. It produces iron and steel. These are all about the iron and steel industry of Karnataka. Third one, give an account of the distribution of cotton textile industry in Karnataka. The modern cotton mills were established towards the end of the 19th century. Ginning and spinning mills were set up in the northern districts. The first MSK cotton mill was set up in 1884 at Kalburgi. Later, cotton textile factories were started in Hubballi. After 1900, big cotton textile mills were established. Among them, Binni Mills and Minerva Mills of Bengaluru, KR Mill of Mysuru, Cotton Mill of Davanagere, etc. were established before independence itself. After independence, cotton mills were set up in the northern Maidan, where cotton was widely grown. Davanagere became the state's most important cotton textile industrial center. It is called Manchester of Karnataka. There are ginning and spinning mills in Hubballi, Ilkal, Guledagudda, Rabakavi, Bagalkot, Malakalmuru, Gadag, Betagiri, Badami, Belagavi, Nargund, Gokak, Ballari, Hunsur, Nanjangud, Periyapatna and Chamrajanagar. At present, there are 14 cotton mills in the state. These are all about the distribution of cotton textile industry in Karnataka. Let's move to question number 4. What factors are essential to start sugar industry? The factors which are essential to start sugar industry are humid climate, power supply, local market, transport system. These are the factors which are essential to start sugar industry. Let's move to question number 5. Mention the reasons for centralization of information technology industry in Bangalore. The reasons for centralization of information technology industry in Bangalore are good climate, electricity supply, technical experts, financial assistance, vast market. These are the reasons for centralization of information technology industry in Bangalore. Let's move to third main. Match the following. List A. Dandeli, Thoranagal, Malakalmuru, Shahabad, Infosys. List B, cement, cotton textile, paper, computers, iron and steel. The correct answer is Dandeli, paper, Thorangal, iron and steel, Molakalmuru, cotton textiles, Shahabad, cement, Infosys, computers.